Our beautiful blue ball of life hangs in a seemingly desolate vacuum of space. We have never found life on any other planet but ours, and life on Earth itself is kind of a mystery. We don't know for sure how life on our planet came to be, but we are trying to figure it out. And in the process, we're finding clues about what we should look for when trying to find other life out there in the universe. The earliest life on Earth recorded in the fossil record are mats of organisms called cyanobacteria, preserved in structures called stromatolites. They're estimated to be about 3.7 billion years old, but we're still not quite sure how this life came to be in the first place. I mean, what was before these? Where the heck did original life on Earth come from?
The basic idea is that early Earth was a very dynamic place. There was lots of building blocks for different things, so building blocks for maybe more complicated, potentially life-building molecules, and there were lots and lots of sources of energy.
When we say life-giving or life-building compounds, we mostly mean amino acids. Amino acids are the building blocks of life because they are what proteins are made of. And proteins form most of the functional parts of our bodies and the rest of Earth's life too. So it's possible that in the beginning, Earth was a hot ball of soup. It could have been that the oceans were full of the ingredients for life called prebiotic molecules, and then the formation of life-giving compounds from these molecules was precipitated by an electrical source, like a lightning strike. Or maybe the prebiotic molecules came from underneath the Earth's crust, bubbling into the oceans from hydrothermal vents where the extreme temperatures and pressures were the impetus for forming life-giving compounds. There are lots of options. But there is one other theory.
It also could have been impact from exogenous sources. So in that case, I mean extraterrestrial sources like astrophysical ices, so comets, meteorites, things like that.
From previous research into the makeup of astrophysical icy bodies like comets, we know that some of them carry glycine, the simplest protein-forming amino acid.
And so then the idea is that the comets, we know that comets could have simple protein-forming amino acids on them like glycine, and that an impact would supply a whole bunch of pressure and temperature which could cause those glycine molecules to clump together in some way and form something interesting.
Something interesting like life? Or at least a precursor to it, because how exactly do we get from one amino acid brought to Earth by a comet to really complex stuff? Like us.
Early Earth was a very hostile environment, and an impact of a comet or something yields very hostile conditions, very high pressures and temperatures. And so what our studies have found, what we've predicted really, is that there's sort of a sweet spot in terms of pressure and temperature space, where if the comet comes in at the right angle and yields these conditions, it could not cause these molecules to decompose, but actually increase complexity. So it causes the molecules to clump together to form more interesting things that are potential life-building precursors.
Neer and his colleagues conduct their studies using what's called quantum mechanical modeling, essentially computer simulations. Then scientists who conduct physical experiments can take the results of simulations like this and more efficiently try to recreate those conditions in a lab to see if the computer simulated predictions match the reality. In a quantum mechanical simulation, we take information that we know, like how electrons behave when chemicals interact with each other. We take that known information in the form of formulas, and we ask the computer to perform numerical calculations with that given set of information under another given set of conditions, like temperatures and pressures.
So this work is really designed to make some kind of specific prediction like that for an experimentalist, like a chemical roadmap. A thermodynamic and chemical roadmap. You know, look at this pressure and temperature space, and then if you do that, we predict you'll find these kinds of molecules.
The team's simulations predict that a certain class of compounds could have resulted from a comet impact with Earth. They're called polycyclic aromatic compounds, or PAHs, and they're really important because they could have gone on to form things like nucleic acids. Those are the building blocks of DNA. So what are the next questions that we need to ask in our search for a little more clarity around the origin of life on Earth?
One thing that's relatively unexplored in this type of astrobiology or origins of life study is how these materials, like these prebiotic mixtures, interact with surfaces. You know, early Earth's ocean wasn't just water and a bunch of organic molecules, there were also silicates, so silicon dioxide surfaces, and other surfaces, metal surfaces, that will act as catalysts for these things. Another interesting avenue we're thinking about is phosphate chemistry. So how did you get these PO4 moieties that are part of DNA, for example? How did those get incorporated into organic matter?
While we're still not exactly sure how life on Earth came to be, this is an exciting step towards confirming the conditions that could have been required. Plus, the simulations tell us more about the conditions and materials we now know would need to be involved. So we can look at that combination almost like a recipe. And that information lets us know that if we see similar combinations of conditions and materials out there in the universe, like on other rocky planets and moons, then they may be capable of forming life too. Make sure you find Lawrence Livermore on all our social media platforms to keep up with our exciting work. And go ahead and subscribe to this channel for more out of this world science. For more videos like this one, check out this playlist over here. As always, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.